Austin from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another masterclass. As a lot of you already probably know, you know, writing or improvising a well-connected melody line can be quite easy when you use the pentatonic scale. It's usually the first scale that we learn when we're going to try to do some guitar solos. But there's a way that you can create even better melody lines with the use of pentatonic scale that directly targets the exact chord being used within a specific measure. Now, this technique of literally tracking chords with pentatonic scales is very effective at creating solid melody parts, because when we use it, we follow nearly the exact same principles as using arpeggios, which obviously connect directly to the chords. So in this lesson, we're going to take a look at how to track chord changes and create well-connected melody lines using specific major, minor, and blues pentatonic scales. Alright, we're going to have some fun with minor pentatonic scale to get started with. We're going to have two chords we're going to work around. It's going to be A minor and also D minor. So those are going to be our two chord shapes that we're going to mess with. And one of the easiest ways, you know, really to start tracking and working through chord changes with pentatonic scales is to just begin with simple chord progression that only uses a couple of chords like this one. You can even start with just one chord and just kind of get the feel over one and then add another one in so you can start flip-flopping between the two pentatonics you're going to operate with. But, you know, when this is done, when you can work with a couple of chords and change quality like that of the chord, eventually moving pentatonics around through more complex chord progressions is going to be easier and easier for you. It's all about following the chords, really. Now, an example one of composed progression that uses these two minor chords in the key of A minor. The changes are just like I said, A minor chord for two measures, and then we're going to move on to D minor chord for two measures as well. So what you want to do is you want to study the melody first, understand how the melody is operating, and then practice using the A minor pentatonic scale in a couple of different areas. You know, find, you know, a couple of positions. Find a few areas to operate within. And you can start with that, cover the A minor, and then what's going to happen is when the D minor chord comes along, you're going to switch and you're going to move over to the D minor pentatonic. You can be in any position that you'd like. Just find your areas of the neck that feel comfortable. Try to overlay, you know, so if you have an A minor in one area and you're going to flip to a D, know where the D is and all that stuff. Now, I have a pre-composed melody here for you. I'll just run through that quickly so you understand how it all operates. It starts on second string. We're just sort of moving through some of the upper tones of the basic A minor pentatonic. And I just went forward out of fifth position up into seventh position, just up to the next pentatonic of A. And I'm just operating a little bit up there. I just moved up, had the seventh and ninth frets. And I'm just moving through them and grabbing that eighth fret. It's the high G there. So I got that high G at eighth fret there. I'm just moving into. Then what's happening is when the D minor chord comes along, I'm going to switch things around a little bit here, and I'm going to start working out of the D minor pentatonic that's more based around the, you know, 8th and 10th frets there. So what happens initially is we move up into 10th position, and we're just moving around a little bit up there in that 10th fret area out of that traditional minor pentatonic shape up there. And then we're shooting down a little bit. And we're going to start moving through some of the tones that are out of pattern. If you have my curriculum, you know, it's going to be pattern number 3. So I'm just moving through that one a little bit there. Move down the neck. And then I'm going to jump into the fifth position with what I have in my curriculum as the pattern number 2. Just drifting a little bit outside there because I'm taking a lower F just for a moment. Taking it right around to the end there at the 5th fret D at the 5th string. So the whole thing is really straightforward. It's just using the two pentatonics, A minor and then D minor. It's a little bit faster ending. It's got a bunch of 16th notes there to it. So work on that. Understand how it's all operating. We're going to take a short break and come back in a moment. We're going to start adding in major and minor pentatonics. So we're going to do both of the qualities coming right up in example two. Improvising a rock lead is a must-have skill for every guitarist. This lesson plan shows how to combine 7-tone scales, arpeggios, and pentatonics to create more interesting rock solos. The focus throughout the lesson plan is placed upon using embellishments like slides, vibrato, bends, hammer-ons, and pull-offs. As a bonus, a complete rock song is included for jamming over at home. Rock lead soloing is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. So next, let's take a look at example number two, where we're tracking major and minor chords with, of course, major and minor pentatonics. So example two gets a little bit more involved here because we're tracking three chords across progression. This means that the skills to follow each chord have to become a little more challenging for you as well. Just, you know, for a short time until you get things into perspective and you're going to get good at it. And then it's not going to seem so hard to do. In the first two measures, we're going to have a C major 7 chord. Now on that chord, of course, what we're going to be doing is playing C major pentatonic. So that's our C major pentatonic on the C major 7 chord. Next up, what happens is we move into a G major 7 chord. And as you probably guessed, we're going to be using G major pentatonic there. So we're covering G major 7 with G major pentatonic. In the last measure, we're going to have an E minor 7 chord. And as you probably guessed, we're going to be doing some E minor pentatonic. We're going to take it a little bit higher on the neck. At that point, though, we're going to be up around 12th fret. So we have a couple of positions we're moving through. I should kind of move through this neck so you understand where we're going on the neck with this stuff. So we're in the middle of the neck starting off. So that's all out of what you'll find in my curriculum as pattern number 4, major pentatonic. That's all covering that 7th position area. Then what we happen to move into there is G major 7's coming around next. And that's just moving through pattern number 1, G major pentatonic. Then after that, we're going to have an E minor 7 chord, like I mentioned, but we're going to jump up the neck a little bit, and that's going to be in 12th position, and we're going to run through a portion of the E minor pentatonic up in 12th fret there, the real traditional shape. Everybody seems to know that shape, right? In the curriculum that I have, it's labeled as pattern number 4 minor pentatonic. So altogether, that melody is moving across those chord changes going like this. There's a fast lick at the end, I should mention, there's a fast lick at the end on the 4th beat. And that's just going to be burning through, taking her up around into that G major 7 chord. So that's happening fairly quick there. Watch yourself on it. It's a pull-off, a slide, and then a hammer-on taking you back in there to the... another slide taking you back into that 7th position. Then after that, we're jumping, we're doing a position shift up the neck into a double stop chord that's at the 4th and 3rd strings, 12th fret there. Let me play the whole thing again, though. From the top, it's going. All right, so that's what we're doing. It's fairly straightforward and easy to understand. You know, you got a major chord, you play major pentatonic. You got a minor chord of any kind, and that's of any kind. It doesn't matter what kind of minor or major chord that you have. If it's a C major triad, C major pentatonic. If it's a C major 7, like we were just playing, C major pentatonic. If it's a C major 6, C major pentatonic. You know, it's whatever chord it is, doesn't matter what it is. You can just play C major pentatonic over everything. That's C major based. Same thing goes when you move to the world of minor. If you've got, like in this progression, we've got that E minor 7, but if it was an E minor triad, still E minor pentatonic. E minor 7, you know, any kind of voicing you could dream up, it's still E minor pentatonic. E minor 9, doesn't matter, you know, E minor 9. E minor 11. You just keep going with these. It's just that simple. More chords you know, the better, of course. You can really color up your progressions a lot more, but the principle remains the same through all this. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a break now. This is the end of part one of this masterclass, and part two, of course, is going to be found in the members area. But when we get to part two, I'm going to be working through some ideas with dominant seventh concepts, because dominant sevenths have a unique concept with them where, you know, you have a dominant chord, you can use the major pentatonic on that. So I'm going to get some demonstrations together with those sounds, tell you to play through that stuff, and we're also going to look at the blues scale as well. Because in the blues, we have a unique opportunity there for the flat five, and I can cover any kind of diminished situation with the flat five. So that's going to be what we're going to look at when we get to part two in the members area. Hopefully you're a member. You can join me on the members area for this. And, you know, when you're a member too, you keep in mind that you get the handout and you get the MP3 jam track for that song that I played at the start of the video. So I'll catch up with you next in the members area. And hopefully we're going to get a lot more ideas together with this by the time the video and the sessions are all done for this masterclass. Be sure to head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com for part two of this lesson in the members area. In part two, we're going to apply pentatonic tracking over some blues scenarios with dominant seventh chords, and I'm going to demonstrate how you can apply the blues scale around some diminished concepts as well. Plus, you want to keep in mind that with the membership, you're not just going to get access to this video lesson for the masterclass here, but you're also going to get the handout, plus you're going to get the MP3 jam track for this lesson as well. So I'll catch up with you next in the members area over at creativeguitarstudio.com. The Music Reading Phase 1 ebook has over 30 pages of comprehensive project lessons covering the entire fifth reading position on the guitar. Music reading charts and drills will work to help students memorize the positions of all the fifth position notes, including important sharp and flat tones. Several original and classic pieces of sheet music will help students to gain a solid understanding for this region of the neck. Rhythm studies, duration examples, plus song and location drills, along with 19 MP3 audio tracks, makes this one of the best music reading courses available. Music Reading Phase 1 is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe to the Creative Guitar Studio YouTube channel and never miss another guitar lesson. Click here to sign up for your free membership to creativeguitarstudio.com. And if you take out a paid membership, you'll get premium content, downloads of jam tracks, lesson handouts, and full access to all the members area video lessons. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time for another guitar lesson. Bye for now. Head over to my blog site at andrewwasson.com for links to my daily blog posts, and be sure to follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, and subscribe to my other guitar blog YouTube channel. All the links are underneath in the show more description box of this video.